Dear students, now we are with the Mancineers team and we are working on the ultrasonic sensor and we'd like to tell you about all the experiences we have here. So first of all, before even starting the ultrasonic sensor program with the PIC, you can use a simple function generator and an oscilloscope to characterize your ultrasonic sensor. Now in this case, maybe I should first start with the channel 1, so I will just stop turn off channel 2 and I will show you what we are doing with channel 1. Now, as you know, the ultrasonic sensor should be able to provide 10 microseconds of pulses to trigger the ultrasonic sensor. So these are the 10 microsecond pulses for the ultrasonic sensor. Now, in this case, I should go to the trigger menu and I should select channel 1 as my trigger so it stops the thing. So this is what I generate with the function generator. And actually, in the actual experiment, in the actual project, of course, you will generate it with the PIC microcontroller, but to check it. Now, in this case, I am using the TTL CMOS output with the 5 volts option for the trigger. Now, as you know, the square wave that I generate has usually a duty cycle of 50-50. It means that I can generate 10 microseconds on, 10 microseconds off. But this is not a very good trigger pulse. Ideally, you'd like to generate a 10 microsecond on pulse and wait for some time, maybe a couple of hundreds of microseconds. Now, in order to generate this as close as possible, what I do is I will need to play with the duty cycle of the function generator. In this case, I should press shift and then the duty cycle, and as you can see, this is 20% duty cycle. I can change it from here. For instance, if I make it 50, which I think I can also write 50 like this. Now, if you look at the oscilloscope, you will see that now it is like a real square wave with 50% duty cycle. Now, I will put this back to 20%, so shift duty, 20%. And as you will see, now I'm generating at 20%. Ideally, I need something like maybe 1% or 2%, but this function generator doesn't let me generate those. So I will have to stick with 20%. So I should do the cycle 20%. And at 20%, I will need to use 20 kilohertz to generate to be able to get the 10 microsecond pulse. Here, for instance, I can, you can see that like if, you know, the step size is 2.5 microseconds, it's right here, and it contains 4 steps like this, so 10 microseconds. Okay, so this is the trigger part. So what happens with the, now if you look at the breadboard, so this trigger goes to the trigger port of the, so in this case, I believe this is the trigger, yeah, trigger port of the ultrasonic sensor. And for the echo part, I am using channel number 2 to read the echo from the ultrasonic sensor, which is a digital output. So if I turn the channel 2 on again and just make it auto set. Now, in this case, the echo pulse will have a larger duration. So for this reason, you will see that the time step is like wider for the channel 2. And if I put my hand on, and you can see the oscilloscope, that the pulse width changes. Of course, there is a problem here. In this experiment, we see interference between different trigger pulses. So for this reason, you know, the width, sometimes you see this jiggling behavior. But the next step in your project should be replacing the function generator with a PIC microcontroller to give nice and like infrequent trigger pulses and take the output to the oscilloscope. And in that case, you can see that you will be able to obtain much nicer pulses. And then the next step after that will be to be able to read out everything on the PIC microcontroller itself. Okay, that's good.